Hi there. In our last session, what we had done is we have created this power supply schematic completely, and now we want to create a simple single-sided PCB out of it. In this video, what we'll do is we'll try to create a layout out of this particular schematic, and then we will study how we can route them. Now, to create the layout out of this schematic, all you need to do is simply click on this button here, which is generate/switch-to-board. So what it will do is it will generate a completely new board file or create a new board file with all those components and all those interconnections. That's called as netlist. So let's just click over here. It will ask you that the board file doesn't exist and do you want to create from schematic? Click on yes. And here we are. So we have all the components and we have a proper black working area. Usually PCB designing area is black because we want to be very clear, because we want to spend much time onto this particular area, and black gives comfort to our eyes. So we have all the components over here, as you can see. Now the next step is to create a layout out of it. Layout means how you want the components to be placed. Some may want a PCB of a square size, some may want a circular size, some may want a rectangular one or a narrow one. All depends upon your choice. I'm going to create a very simple PCB now. And the key to designing a simple PCB is to know how to place your components properly. So this is the DC jack that we had used. And here I have to look here. So SL1 is my input connector. So I'll look for SL1 first. This is my input connector. I'll just place it over here. Then I have placed power jack and SL connector. Now D1, D2, D3, D4 needs to be placed. Now it's natural that your layout or the placement of component should be in a completely natural fashion. So if I connect D1 here, then the most suitable configuration of connecting D2 is like this, where there is an interconnection between this anode and this cathode. If I place D1 here, and then if I place the D2 here, and if I then place D3 somewhere here, it's not going to work. So what we need to do is place them as close to each other's connection as possible, like this. Again, right click will rotate your component. And then lastly, this D4. That's it. Next is the capacitor. Follow the schematic. As the components are placed in schematic, you can follow the same way to the here. If you are facing any difficulty in moving the components, you can use the command move. So with move command, you can easily move a component by clicking anywhere onto it, like this. This is the capacitor. I want to place it like this. Then this is the 7805. Let's put it here, like this. Then comes the resistor and the LED. So LED is like this and resistor should be like this. And this is my output connector. If you look closely, the flat side is the cathode of LED and the rounded side is anode. Now this is how my PCB should look like, or this is how my component should be placed. This should be as proper as possible. Components as close to their interconnection as possible. There should not be any jumbling in placing the components. So that's it for this video. Next session, we'll see how we can route this to create a single-sided PCB.